this edition of Growth Point. And I hope you're enjoying these YouTube devotionals. And if you are, I hope you'll share them with a friend and encourage others to take this journey with us. It's a journey in the book of Proverbs where we're seeking to have wisdom to lead us on the right path. And I want to finish today this section of Proverbs 6 that tells us some things the Lord really hates. And even though he is a God of love, he loves the world, he wants to bring the world to redemption through his son, Jesus Christ. Nevertheless, there are things, sinful things, that God says, I really hate this. I want you to know. What are those things? We should care about it. And we're going to read in Proverbs 6:16, these six things doth the Lord hate, yea, seven are an abomination to him. A proud look, a lying tongue, and hands that shed innocent blood, an heart that deviseth wicked imaginations, feet that are swift to running in mischief, a false witness that speaketh lies, and he that soweth discord among the brethren. Now, we saw last time the meaning of the proud look and the fact that Satan himself in the book of Isaiah said, I will ascend to the Most High. I will be like the Most High. That's really a great definition of pride. Pride is when we try to take the place of God or when we exalt ourselves above the place of God in our own minds. We become some kind of a spiritual legend in our own minds. And God says, when you get to that point of autonomy that I'm not even in the thought process, that's a problem. And there are so many today who never even think of God. And they forget about him completely. And this proud look is displeasing. We saw, secondly, the lying tongue, that the Bible teaches us in the book of Ephesians to speak the truth in love, and that God's people are to be people of the truth. And sometimes it feels like, well, this is inconvenient to tell the truth. And we've seen churches that have sin problems within the church. And rather than just tell the truth, rather than just say, hey, there's been a sin, there's been a victim involved, rather than apologizing to the victim and repenting of the sin, they just try to, you know, somehow ship the problem down to the next church. And we really understand, if we get into the Word, that that speaking the truth is God's formula always. And it says such things as, you know, rebuke before all that others may fear. And we see in the Scriptures, with respect to Matthew 18, the forms of church discipline that are to be based upon the truth established by witnesses brought before the church at times. Why? Because if there cannot be truth in the church, then this society is without a faithful witness. So God says, I hate the lying tongue. And then we learned last time that he hates hands that shed innocent blood, whether that is murder or whether that is murder by abortion. God does not prohibit a nation from defending herself in time of war, but he certainly hates the thought and the action of taking innocent life. And certainly abortion is right at the top when it comes to so many innocent children with a beating heart having their lives snuffed out from them. And we need to pray for repentance in our land. And thankfully, there have been some victories in this area, but many today disregard life. And God says, I hate the hands that shed innocent blood. And then we learned he hates the heart that deviseth wicked imaginations. And we learned about the fact that there are industries where men are paid full-time for devising wicked imaginations, both in the entertainment industry and in the profession of politics. People who write laws, such as those in Sacramento, who write laws that a 10-year-old child, a 10-year-old girl, can have a mastectomy if they're struggling through some form of psychological difficulty and think that they want to change their sexual identity. The people who write these laws are going to face the judgment of God someday. But I do want to say it's not just a rule for the unbeliever. It is I believe, a rule and a caution for the believer who constantly thinks about wickedness, whether that be through forms of pornography or evil television or gaming that they're involved in. Yes, God says, I hate those who think about it, who write it, who devise it, the heart of that one. But God says also to, I believe, a believer, that this is something that should be avoided in the life of a Christian. He doesn't want your time, your heart, being consumed by evil imaginations continually. That was definitely the era of Noah. Men did that. They were just constantly in their hearts thinking and doing that which was evil. And obviously God brought judgment. No doubt that was the case with Sodom and Gomorrah. And we thank God for his word because it faithfully reminds us in this day of the importance of avoiding such thoughts and actions. Well, we want to pick it up where we left off. And the next phrase that we find here in Proverbs is this that simply says a heart that deviseth wicked imaginations and then feet that be swift in running to mischief. And this is an interesting part of Proverbs 6. Feet that be swift in running to mischief. This really speaks about the person that is constantly involving themselves in sin, whether it be theft, whether it be those that want to run to another parade. I have seen even Christians who just really don't study some of the parades and some of the picketing. They don't study the real background behind groups maybe like Black Lives Matter, whose website spoke against the traditional family, spoke for communism, spoke for other sinful activities. And yes, we want to have justice for all, but to run and march and to be involved in activities just because of the emotional frothiness of that is something that a believer is cautioned with. And many times there's mischief involved in those things. And even people on the opposite sides of those issues go to these events. Sometimes fights erupt. Sometimes arguments erupt. Sometimes people get online and argue against each other. And people have actually been beaten and killed just because they all ran to something without researching who's behind this, what's going on, and so forth. And I truly believe that there are people that run to the wrong causes and find trouble there. There are people that run with the wrong crowd and fall into crime. Many people today are in prison today simply because they ran to mischief. They went to a party, they took some alcohol, they hung with the wrong friend, invested with the wrong people into some scheme of things. So there needs to be a caution about running to mischief. And we see today many times people that are in the big cities and so forth beaten and others just laughing and videoing it. And God says, I hate that. I hate people that run to mischief simply to stir something up, to get angry at whatever they're getting angry at, because oftentimes it leads to more trouble. Let me encourage you. The Bible says, let your moderation be known. That word is sweet peaceableness. And you find that in the book of Philippians chapter 4. And God does not say, exalt your anger, exalt your pride, join with others that are going to give a piece of their mind or go hurt somebody. God says, I hate those feet that run to mischief. And then the next one that he mentions is this. He says, not only the feet that run to mischief, but a false witness that speaketh lies. A false witness that speaketh lies. We've seen in recent days people that actually lie simply to hurt others or advance their own political cause. I think of the nomination of Justice Kavanaugh to the Supreme Court. From everything that I've seen and studied, a decent family guy, people literally went to courts of law, sat in chairs, told just completely fabricated stories on the man to try to keep him from ascending to the Supreme Court. False witness that speaks lies. And we've seen this in the Christian world as well. The Bible says in Matthew 4:9, blessed are the peacemakers. Psalm 120 verse 2, deliver my soul, O Lord, from lying lips and from a deceitful tongue. The fact is that this behavior is common in our society today, but should not be spoken of regarding Christians. And so God says, I hate a false witness that speaketh lies. And then number 7, he that soweth discord among the brethren. That's someone who's just creating conflict. And notice here the word brethren. I really think there's an application for the church and for the believers in particular. Sowing means scattering seeds. Discord means strife, contention, and disagreement. Boy, I tell you, there are some people, this is what they focus on. If you don't have friends who focus mostly on the Lord, the things of God, the things that are true and lovely, find some new friends or be a different friend. show an indifference toward those that are always sowing discord, and according to this passage, amongst the brethren. Proverbs 6:14 says it this way, "Frowardness is in his heart. He deviseth mischief continually." Proverbs 16:28, "A froward mouth soweth strife." Romans 16 gets even more direct for us who are believers. It says, "I beseech you, brethren, mark them which cause divisions and offenses contrary to the doctrine which you have learned, and avoid them, for they are such that serve not our Lord Jesus Christ, but their own belly, by good words and fair speeches deceive the hearts of the simple." And so we see in these passages that God is commending to us a walk that is without discord, without sowing discord. And if there's ever been a time when believers need to stand united in truth and pray for one another, this is certainly that time. There are a myriad of subjects that people become divisive over, and causes that people try to draw one another into. Most of these nuances and interpretations are not worth the division. I believe in contending for the faith. I believe in standing on the truth of the Word of God. But I don't want to sow discord over a philosophy of man. And I want to encourage you today to understand that God hates these things. These seven things are an abomination to him. And we want to hate what God hates and love what God loves. I pray that you'll encourage others to join with us as we continue this journey through the book of Proverbs, and that each and every day we might be able to be strengthened in God's word. And we're going to continue building this YouTube channel with content that I trust will be helpful and encouraging. And we may be interspersing some posts from upcoming journeys that we'll be taking with our church family into some Bible and church history. But wherever we meet with you, we look forward to it. We pray that God blesses you richly as you walk on his path of wisdom today.